Hello and welcome to a new video here on my channel here at commaikE. In my project series on building a lawn irrigation system with Hunter, today I will connect the valve from the distribution box to my lawn irrigation computer using Hunter MP rotators. Connect. I'll show you how I do that in this video. Stay tuned, we're starting soon. In the last videos of this project series, you have seen how I have planned the Hunter MP rotator's lawn irrigation system. You have seen how I laid the pipes. I have laid the pipes, installed the sprinklers, and how I set up the water distributor. I have installed my valve box. My Rainbird distributor has a valve. With this, the valve controls the irrigation for the entire lawn area. This valve is intended to... I will now connect with my lawn irrigation computer. After that, the control will be completely conveniently via the computer or smart the PC or phone. I have placed the valve box on, installed in the area to be irrigated, and the valve is located inside the distribution box at the distribution station. With these two cables, I will establish the connection to my irrigation computer. The X-core is located at a distance of approximately 15 running meters in the house. In order to lay the cable invisibly, I have during the installation. I have already installed conduit in the ground. I will run the cable through the conduit, pull into my house where I can safely and securely connect the cable to the irrigation computer. On the other side, I have also laid two conduits. With these conduits, I can later run additional cables to the other lawn areas, the gabion slope and the raised beds. I will set up a distribution system in this valve box from which I will connect the other cables. Can be installed in all directions. To connect the valve to my Hunter irrigation computer, like I use a cable that I have already used multiple times. This cable provides, it comes in various designs. The designation is YSLide JZ. I have a variant with five conductors of 0.75 millitwos each. I will safely connect this cable to the valve. I will do that. I in this distribution box so that the contacts are water protected. When the distribution box, once I finish later and have connected the other cables as well, I will install a larger distribution box. I will then fill it with an epoxy resin to make it to provide permanent protection against water. On the other hand, this cable is pulled through the conduit and connected to my Hunter X-Core irrigation computer. It is important to have the right number to know the wires and to order the correct cable. You need one per valve, a ground cable, and a cable for the voltage. It doesn't matter if it's the left or right. Cables are connected to the positive or negative terminal. For two valves, you only need one ground cable, but essentially two cables for the voltage. In total, the formula is number of valves plus one approximately. Due to the short distances from the valve box to the house wall, I might be able to use the control cable. Still push it through by hand. The cable is relatively soft. It can be managed over longer distances. Definitely no more pushing stretches. It must be pulled. So far, I have one. Nylon threading wire is used. This threading wire can be found at hardware stores or online. This model has a length of approximately 15 meters, and it specifically has a guiding spring at the front. At the other end, there is a loop at which the cable, which you want to pull through the conduit, is secured. This threading wire has worked in the past, but it is not perfect. The reason is actually quite simple. This threading aid wraps into each other. It gets tangled as soon as I remove the cable ties. It's a struggle every time to get started, to find without the rest getting tangled behind it. Unfortunately, the nylon wire is very smooth and therefore it can easily get tangled. When you pull it through a damp area, if I then have to pull hard, I slid off very quickly. The pulling of the cables works, but it is very tedious. I will most likely be allowed to work on a larger project soon to help build. A lot of cables need to be run there, not just for the lawn irrigation, but also in the house. There we need cables for the electricity and for the network. I have chosen a larger, better option for threading the cables. I found what I was looking for with this model from Vivor. I have already used Vivor products in my... I used a garden kitchen. I had never heard of the company Vivor before. But I am satisfied with my garden furniture. I hope to have the same experience again here. Get a great product. This threading aid has a length of 130 meters. The wire is made of fiberglass. I can also connect the new cable here at the loop and it to an extremely long length all by myself threading without needing the help of a second person. I haven't tried this threading wire yet. I'm going to do that today. I'm really excited whether that was the right decision. I have run the control cable into my conduit. I pulled in the other end of the cable and the cable from the solenoid valve into the junction box. Introduced, the box is not waterproof, therefore I will place it a bit higher later. Secure. As soon as I connect the remaining cables from the other conduits, I will carefully fill the box with an epoxy resin. I have the two cables here and I will connect them securely and ensure everything is in place. From the solenoid valve that I now want to connect with this control cable, I have the control cable already stripped. You see a total of 5 wires, of which 4 wires are black, I hope. As you can see, there is a number embossed on the wires. Here it says number 3. Here the number 4 is embossed. The black veins are continuously numbered. This makes the installation is of course much easier when I have the cable on the other side with connect to the Hunter irrigation computer. The yellow-green cable is not allowed, at least in Germany. Should not be used as a live cable. I have been reminded of this often enough. I would like to say at this point, yes, it is not approved for that. Nevertheless, I use it as a mass cable since it visually differs from the other cables. It is about a control cable. Important. However, please note this information. I will now connect the cable with cable number 1. I don't need the other 3 wires at the moment. I'll just leave that lying there. To make it fit better, I'll shorten the cable a bit. Then I carefully strip the cable ends. Subsequently, the ground cable and the voltage cable are securely connected to one of the 2 red terminals in order to ensure proper connection. Cables connected carefully from the solenoid valve. The cable ends can be twisted together, knotted, or over. Normal terminal blocks will be connected, since I will be expanding the system shortly. To begin with, I first utilize a standard Wago terminal with a lever. The strands from the electrical control cable are all fine stranded. You cannot insert them into a normal Wago terminal. Therefore, I use the terminals are specifically designed for secure clipping purposes. Initially, you clip one side securely using the first terminal. After ensuring that the first side is properly clipped and stable, you proceed to add a second terminal to the opposite side. This process ensures that both sides are securely clipped, providing a stable and reliable connection. The use of 2 terminals in this manner. The other cable end, the red cable is still a bit long. I will strip it. I'll trim it a little. The beauty of these transparent terminals is that you can see very well on the back whether the cable has proper contact. I carefully pull the cables back slightly in my box to check to ensure everything is correct. I will forgo a strain relief since the expansion is anticipated to continue shortly and is expected to do so in the near future. Once the lid is on, I will be finished on this side. At this point, a brief note, the junction box, the cable, the Wago terminals and all. You can find other materials that I use here for the construction of my lawn irrigation system under the video in the video description. Take a look there. You can access it through the links. Reorder materials quickly and conveniently. Now let's move on. Off to the irrigation computer. I have passed the control cable through the wall into my irrigation computer. Introduced. You see, with the yellow-green cable and the black cable with the number 1, I have already removed the insulation. I will set aside cables 2, 3 and 4. I will use them later. Not connect at the moment, I will do that later. My Hunter irrigation computer has already connected a variety of cables in the lower area, right at the front, 24 volts. This is the connection from the transformer, from the power supply. This irrigation computer is for indoor use. The model for outdoor use has an integrated transformer. Here you are working directly with 220 volts. Here only 24 volts are present. My sensor has, I am currently bypassing it. The rain sensor is therefore not connected. It will get exciting from here. From C to 8. The C stands for capacity, for the mass. Here it is already. The yellow-green cable connected, which links my previous 6 irrigation circuits to the ground. And also supplied. I have also connected valves 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. I will now place the new valve on 7. To do this, I will first loosen the screw slightly. Before I just a little bit more, very slowly and carefully tighten the cable. I will add the ground wire to the already existing ground wire. Tighten. There is enough space, if the space is no longer sufficient. Since you may have introduced more cables, you can set up an additional distributor in advance. Install. There, all ground wires are clamped onto a single ground wire, which then is connected to the C-clamp. With that, I am already finished and can perform a test, whether the whole thing even works. Before I reprogram the irrigation controller, I set the rotary switch to the manual section. You see, the system wants to activate irrigation zone 1. Automatically irrigate. I click further until number 7 and set the duration to 2 minutes. Then I turn the switch back to operation. Now the irrigation should start. You see the display is blinking and the irrigation is running. The test was successful. I put the cover back on the irrigation controller so that it looks really nice and the cables are hidden. I can manually start the new irrigation zone. I just tried that and it works. However, my goal is to automate the irrigation. Automate, that's why I have this Hunter irrigation controller. I'll show you how it works. I will now address you. But first, a small note regarding my own matter. If you have enjoyed this video so far, if you like it, then give me a thumbs up, a like. If you haven't done so yet, subscribe to my channel. Just click the subscribe button at the bottom right and no. Don't miss any new videos. You can find all materials and components below the video. Description. Feel free to check it out if you're interested. Just click on the links. And order. Same price for you and a small commission for me and my channel. Further, let's proceed with the programming of the Hunter X Core. I have already set up my programming in the menu for the first 6 irrigation zones have been set up, and now I want to program a 7th zone, the 7th. The zone should also be programmed into zone A, the main zone. I want all my lawns in a passage should be irrigated, all at a start time on one day. Should I? Notice that my new lawn has more shade and requires less water. I can reduce the watering time per cycle, or I can create a second program B, which starts less often than the main program A that I'm already using. I switch with the rotary switch to the menu settings day hour. Here it shows 2022. My data is all stored. Today is August 24th at 4:57 p.m. I could change and reset this here, but I do not want that. My goal is simply to create a new irrigation zone. I have scheduled my first irrigation zone to start at 04:45 a.m. I currently do not have a second irrigation zone. No third or fourth party is involved with this computer. This X-Core irrigation controller waters exclusively my lawn areas. I could now program a second irrigation zone that is independent of the 1. Zone A works as long as the times do not overlap. Otherwise, the programs run sequentially. The first irrigation zone is sufficient. I turn the switch further to the setting irrigation duration. Currently, I have an irrigation duration of the irrigation zone number 1, 16 minutes. I switch to irrigation zone number 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. There are also 15 minutes. On the 7th, there is a 0. This means that this irrigation zone is currently not activated. It is not starting. I would like to change that now and temporarily set the runtime to 5 minutes. Increase. This way, I can check if the start and stop actually work automatically. I have increased the duration to 5 minutes using the plus button. The plus button and the minus button are so far self-explanatory. That was it already. If I click further to the right, here comes the 8th irrigation zone. It is not yet connected and therefore is set to 0. When I back on the 7th, it shows my 5 minutes again. The irrigation days are currently Monday and Thursday. There you can see the raindrops on the display. Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday. Saturday and Sunday are crossed out. On these days, irrigation is currently not taking place. I have already shown you the seasonal adjustment solar sink in another video. Take a look. Top right. There I will link the video. I turn the switch to normal operation and should. Now normally wait until the next irrigation day comes. That would be the case Thursday. At 4:45 a.m., irrigation zone number one would run first. After that, the second. Then the third, and so on. For the seventh irrigation zone, I could then schedule it for sometime around 06:30. Look out the window, then my new irrigation zone should start running. So you see, it's not that difficult to program the Hunter X-Core irrigation controller. I will not test the program now because my manual test worked. The rest works as well. You can save the program permanently. For this, I use, here is this small card from Hunter. All the shortcuts are listed there. Under, among other things, the run of all stored programs. To do this, you simply need to press and hold longer on the press the right button. In my case, this would now manually start program A. I don't want that though. That's why I turn it off again and switch the lever back to operation. I will check if tomorrow morning at 06:15 or 06:30, when the first six irrigation zones have run through, the seven zone actually starts up properly. I have shown you how to easily connect your solenoid valves in the valve box. You can connect the lawn irrigation controller. I primarily use products from Hunter or Rainbird. In principle, it should work with any other irrigation controller as well. Work the same way. It is important that the voltage matches. In my case, that is 24 voltage at the valves and 24 volts that the irrigation controller outputs for control. In the next video, I will show you how to individually adjust the Hunter MP rotator lawn sprinklers. Can be adjusted, I will show you how to change the start angle, how you change the throw angle, and how you change the throw distance. You will see all of this you in a new video of mine. If you don't want to miss it, remember to subscribe. Leave me a comment and share your questions, feedback, and critiques about this video. I'm really looking forward to it. Please give me a like if you enjoyed this video. Take a look at the description and use my product links to support my channel. Support, I would be really happy about that. Until next time. Take care. Bye.